Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today we're talking about performance modifications for the Duramax LB7. Fortunately, the LB7 was built very well from the factory and therefore can handle a pretty good amount of additional power just from basic bolt-on modifications. The LB7 can push right up to about 500 wheel horsepower before things start getting expensive and you start needing some more advanced upgrades and modifications. Going beyond the 500 to 550 wheel horsepower range is when things start to get pretty expensive modifying the LB7. And so today we're gonna focus mostly on basic bolt-on modifications for those people that are looking to add a couple hundred horsepower without having to spend more than a couple thousand dollars and without sacrificing any reliability or engine longevity. So before we jump into the modifications here, let's go ahead and talk about the power limits that you'll run into when you try to do an LB7 build. The first one's gonna be the transmission. The transmission is good for about 500 wheel horsepower. Now, you will definitely lose a good bit of reliability at 500 wheel horsepower. It'll be pretty reliable with transmission tuning around the 450 range. And it can handle over 500, but you're gonna be needing to look at a built transmission if you wanna push too much past it or if you want to reliably hold above 500. Additionally, at the 500 wheel horsepower limit is the lift pump. The rest of the fueling system, we have the injectors. The factory injectors are good for about 600. And the factory CP3 can handle over 600 wheel horsepower as well. So the fueling system is pretty strong. The lift pump is just the first thing that needs upgrading there. And then really above 550 or 575 is when you would definitely want to start considering some injector upgrades. The last thing on the list is the factory turbocharger. The factory turbo is good for about 525 to maybe 550 wheel horsepower. However, above the 520 level is really when the turbo starts to run really hot, and so your EGTs are gonna suffer, and it's gonna put you in a position to potentially bend a rod. You'll want to look at turbocharger upgrades if you're really trying to push above that 500 wheel horsepower level as well. When you think about all of those more advanced mods, it can get pretty expensive to get things over 500, which is why today we're gonna focus on the things that can get you to 500. We'll do another video down the line talking about turbo upgrades and more advanced modifications for the LB7. But for today, let's go ahead and jump into our basic bolt-ons. We're going to go ahead and cover four modifications here. These four modifications are going to cost you somewhere around $1,000 to $1,500 and we'll be able to add over 200 wheel horsepower. This is extreme bang for your buck, a lot of horsepower per dollar spent here. So let's go ahead and jump into it. The first thing is engine tuning. Now, EFI Live is going to be hands down the best tuning platform here. You can do EFI Live with transmission tuning as well, which I certainly recommend if you're gonna push past probably 425 wheel horsepower. That's when it's good to put transmission tuning on to go ahead and help your transmission hold those higher power levels reliably. The caveat with EFI Live, especially when you start to add transmission tuning, is you're gonna be looking at $1,000 or $1,500 plus dollars to go ahead and get into that. And so if you're looking just to add a little bit of additional power, you just want an easy plug and play system, and you're just planning on doing these four modifications that we talk about, then you can opt for a standard plug and play device. The best one for the Duramax LB7 is the PPE accelerator. It's plug and play, it costs $450, and it comes with five standard tunes on it that range from plus 40 to plus 225 horsepower. So EFI Live is gonna be the best bet, especially if you want transmission tuning, but it's not really necessary if you don't plan on going above that 400 wheel horsepower range. The second thing on our list is a downpipe back exhaust. Now, downpipe upgrades are a thing for the LB7, but all of the exhaust systems that you find out there are gonna be downpipe back because the downpipes bolt up separately and they're probably a little bit less popular to upgrade. And so we're talking about the two separately since we've got downpipe back systems on the market here. An exhaust system is probably one of the most important modifications for lowering EGTs. And so it helps a ton with turbocharger reliability, as well as overall engine health by helping keep EGTs lower and reduce the amount of stress that's being put on the turbocharger. Once you add tuning, that really adds more power by increasing the boost level that the turbo's running, which then creates more exhaust gases that have to leave the engine. If they can't leave quickly enough, it creates exhaust back pressure. That back pressure works against the turbocharger and acts as a force against its spooling. And so reducing the back pressure is going to reduce stress on the turbo, give you faster turbo spool, lower EGTs, and give you a more efficient turbo, which then results in power gains as well. We always recommend going with a straight exhaust and not opting for a muffler. The mufflers create a little bit of back pressure, and so you just get better performance out of a straight pipe exhaust system. For the LB7, a 4-inch downpipe back exhaust is all you need. If you're planning on upgrading the turbo and shooting for really high horsepower levels, then I'd recommend going for a 5-inch system, but 5 inches really isn't needed with the factory turbocharger. Aluminum is the best value here. Aluminum's gonna be cheaper than steel. It's gonna last not quite as long, but the steel systems in the LB7 do tend to drone a bit more just because of the material. And so we prefer the sound of the aluminum one, and it's the best value play out there. An MBRP 4-inch aluminum back exhaust is $399. Which is gonna be hands down the best bang for the buck exhaust system that's out there and the one that we would recommend. The third thing on the list is an intake system. Now that we have engine tuning and we have an exhaust system, it's gonna be important to bring more air to the turbocharger to help assist the turbocharger and increase its efficiency. You're gonna see some power gains out of this just by supplying the turbo with more air, but you're also gonna get some other worthwhile benefits. You'll typically see a 1 to 2 mile per gallon increase in fuel economy, which over time pays for itself. And you're also gonna get better throttle response out of it as well. For high horsepower builds, we prefer an open intake system. However, if you're just looking at doing what we've got on our list here, then using a closed box intake from Banks Power or S&B is going to provide enough airflow increases to get the job done. The fourth thing on our list, which I'm not gonna say is a necessity, but is definitely recommended if you're up for the challenge, is a downpipe upgrade. The downpipe is really the most restrictive piece of the exhaust system on the LB7. Therefore, it's the most important thing to upgrade and the part of the exhaust where you're gonna see the biggest impact from. Upgrading the downpipe is gonna give you the biggest power gains, it's gonna give you the biggest EGT reduction, and it's gonna give you the biggest back pressure reduction. It's a great modification if you're up for the task of installing it. The reason that I say it's optional and I put it last on the list is that installing it is a complete pain and sometimes requires dropping the transmission or getting the transmission out of the way to access the place where the downpipe bolts up to. So it's a tough DIY install, but it's completely worth it if you're up for the task or if you're already in the area and have the clearance. Downpipes are pretty cheap. You can get a PPE one for about $170. And so it's definitely a great modification to consider. So that covers it on our list of basic bolt-on modifications with tuning, an exhaust system, a cold air intake, and maybe a downpipe. You should pretty easily be able to push over 500 wheel horsepower on the LB7 without any additional upgrades. Now, I will note if you're running on the most aggressive tune, whether it's the plus 225 horsepower PPE one, or you get EFI Live and run an aggressive tune there, you might run into some issues down the road with things like your transmission and the other things that tend to be a problem once you start pushing up to that 500 wheel horsepower range, like the turbocharger as well. So some other modifications to consider that are good mods to add, but not required by any means, is an intake horn and a Y-bridge. That'll just help supply more airflow. It'll help lower EGTs and help reduce some stress on the turbocharger as well. An intercooler and intercooler piping is a great upgrade to help lower EGTs, especially if you do a lot of towing. Intercoolers are just expensive, and the one on the LB7 7 is good enough to not really need it until you get to very high power levels. Upgrading the lift pump doesn't hurt, just because that's the first limit of the fueling system at about 500 wheel horsepower. And then transmission tuning is a great thing to add as well if you're going the EFI Live route. The last thing is going to be monitoring, whether you're adding analog gauges or using a digital gauge like the Insight CTS3. Keeping an eye on boost pressure, EGTs, trans temps is extremely important to make sure that you keep your truck within the limits and within the specs that you should, because the LB7s are known to bend rods once you start putting a little bit too much heat and a little bit too much power together with them. So this is gonna get you right up around that 500 wheel horsepower range. To get past that, a built transmission is gonna run you $5,000 or $6,000. You're definitely gonna need custom tuning. To get beyond the 600 or too deep into the 600 territory, you're gonna need a turbocharger, injectors, and so on. To reliably push 600 wheel horsepower, you're gonna be looking at $12,000 to $15,000, and you still might have the possibility of bending some rods at those levels. Anyways, guys, that covers it for our guide on basic bolt-on modifications for the LB7. We're gonna continue to do a series on the LB7 as well as the other Duramax, where we jump into more upgrades for the LB7, like turbocharger upgrades, injector upgrades, and every other thing that we discussed today but didn't go in depth on. So if you're looking forward to that content, please subscribe to the channel, click the like button here, and stay tuned.